The first nuclear-powered cargo passenger ship traveled from the US to Europe 50 years ago to promote the atomic age. That didn't work. The sleek red and white NS Savannah was unlike any other cargo ship. Its interior was decked in the modern chrome. It was a pioneering cruise ship. To prove nuclear propulsion's safety and reliability for civilian usage, the NS Savannah carried passengers and cargo. Savannah's speed and reliability exceeded its designers' expectations, making it an engineering success. Savannah inspired other nations to create nuclear-powered cargo ships. The once-famous ship was retired after 5 years. Just as it started, the ideal of a cleaner, more efficient nuclear-powered future would end. Hello guys, welcome back to our channel. Today we will talk about the ship that totally failed to change the world. The $50 million NS Savannah launched 55 years ago this week. The first nuclear-powered merchant ship was to represent safety and faith in the future's fuel. Savannah NS Savannah would prove that nuclear power was safe, clean, and nearly infinite, revolutionizing ships. An average ship burns around 20,000 barrels of bunker oil to circumnavigate the globe, emitting poisonous smoke. The NS Savannah was built to make that trip without burning anything, because it could circle the world using nuclear fuel. Replacing an oil-burning engine with a tiny nuclear reactor would make future ships faster, cheaper, and more reliable. It would also free up freight and passenger space by eliminating bulky fuel tanks. Nuclear-powered ships might travel faster and for years without refueling. New trade routes could change maritime trade. The world has cause to doubt nuclear power's claims. 1950s nuclear meant one thing: radiation's hidden hazards and massive destructive power were feared. In 1953, Eisenhower established Atoms for Peace. To promote the peaceful use of nuclear energy, research, funds, and equipment would be sent worldwide. The NS Savannah would represent an atomic-powered future on the water. The ship was the first to carry passengers and goods. The NS Savannah was futuristic. This ship was built to stand out, from the teardrop-shaped superstructure to the sleek cargo cranes. The power plant distinguished it. Refueling the Savannah's 74-milliwatt cylindrical reactor is from above. The pressurized water reactor, primary coolant loop, and steam generator share a 50-foot lead, concrete, and polyethylene containment tank. Engineers added layers of safety to keep passengers and staff safe mere meters from the reactor. A primary radiation barrier, thick steel containment vessel, and 500-ton biological shield surround the reactor. Savannah was one of the first ships to use hydraulically actuated fins to stabilize against extreme weather. To prevent ship collisions, the ship had a strengthened hull and energy-absorbing features. If Savannah sank, one-way valves would flood the containment vessel with seawater to prevent radioactive material from escaping. Savannah's builders boasted that they were the safest ever built after engineers considered every calamity scenario. It only remained to convince the world. The Savannah left for a European cruise in September of 1964, making stops at Rotterdam, Bremen, Hamburg, Dublin, and Southampton. The docks were crowded with curious onlookers, and thousands of people, including politicians and business moguls, boarded to take a look around. It was a masterpiece of public relations, NS Savannah Association President Will Davis said. The excitement was built up everywhere it went because images were given ahead of time. The goal was to demonstrate to other countries that nuclear power is safe and beneficial. Although it was a thrilling ride, Savannah's diplomatic mission ultimately failed. A year after the completion of the ambassadorial voyage, the world was still not convinced that nuclear-powered ships were the way of the future, despite Savannah's best efforts. Most merchant ships today consume low-grade bunker oil, worst oil. One huge cargo ship can emit 50 million automobiles worth of sulfur dioxide. Shipping-related pollutants cause 400,000 premature deaths from lung cancer and cardiovascular disease each year, while the public is focused on nuclear power's risks. Just a dozen nuclear-powered cargo ships would significantly reduce world emissions. The US military has operated hundreds of nuclear-powered vessels securely for 50 years. Nuclear technology has improved since Savannah set sail 60 years ago. Nuclear-powered civilian ships are still in development. Still, public perception remains the major challenge. Thanks for watching. We'll meet you soon with our next video, and make sure to subscribe to our channel right now if you haven't already.